Hi, good morning. Today, Monday, I'm going to share with you on basic understanding on quantitative versus qualitative and also mixed method. Please pay attention to this lecture because it's gonna also involve your third assignment. Okay, so basically, this lecture will also combine with will give explanation to the upcoming assignment. All right, so basically, what you need to know that in research, we have quantitative, qualitative, and also mixed method. All right, so what is quantitative and qualitative, and how do these differ by research tradition? All right, when you talk about collecting and analyzing data that involve numbers and statistics, then it is about quantitative. Qualitative, in other words, deals with words and meanings. So both are important for gaining different kinds of knowledge. So if you remember that some of your conceptual framework, you have variables, correct? So if you're talking about variables, then it falls under quantitative. But if you don't provide variables, if you don't have variables, then it is called, or it is what we assume as a qualitative research. All right, so quantitative research, as I said, expressed in numbers and graph. So basically, if you provide a lot of graph, or if you see study that have a graph, a pie chart, okay, and all of these diagram, then it is mostly is quantitative. Normally it involve experiments, observations, recorded as numbers, and surveys with closed-ended questions. Okay, let's say you want to dispute a questionnaire, okay, to all architecture students in UPM, okay, in Faculty of Design and Architecture. So let's say we have about 200 students from first year, part one and part two, okay. So we have like 200 students. So you want to distribute questionnaire to them, then it's definitely a quantitative study. Well, qualitative is expressed through words. Okay, you use qualitative to understand concepts, thoughts, or experiences. Okay, this type of research enables you to gather in-depth insights on topics that are not well understood. Okay, if you want to discover something that still not available, still not available or still underexplored, okay, in the context of Malaysia, for example. So you cannot do quantitative because you cannot do survey towards people who doesn't know what to answer, right? So you have to opt for qualitative in order to explore what would be their response, what would be their feedback, okay, much more in-depth. Okay, you cannot just yes or no. All right, so qualitative include interviews with open-ended questions and observation described in words and literature review that explore concepts and theories. Right, here you can see the most common difference between quantitative and qualitative. So basically, what I'm going to show here, the hypothesis, okay, that available in quantitative. Okay, so pertaining to your assignment, if you choose quantitative, I hope you can highlight the hypothesis part in the selected study, and then you can highlight what is the hypothesis and how the authors achieve or comply to the hypothesis, or answer the hypothesis. But in terms of qualitative, basically there's no hypothesis, and it's just themes that develop after you complete the analysis. So if you choose qualitative, please make sure that you highlight the study or the themes that come up from the study, and then show what is actually the discussion is all about. Okay, so it depends on what method that you choose. Okay, you have to show the strength and the weakness of each methods. Alright, for quantitative research, it focuses on testing theories and hypotheses. Okay, the theory should be available, and then you want to test it in a different context. So then you will test the theories in the different contexts. Okay, but qualitative is focusing on exploring ideas and formulating a theory or hypothesis. So at the end of the study, there will be a theory or hypothesis or a framework, okay, based on your study. So it's totally different approach already. Okay, and then of course quantitative will be analyzed through math and statistical analysis, whereas qualitative is more on summarized, categorizing and interpretation. All right so those who choose quantitative, I want you to highlight the analysis part. Okay, how the what is actually the strategy, the statistical analysis, okay, the type of statistic analysis that been conducted in that study, and then how many respondents that being used, and then what are the, okay, if you can find the survey questions, what are the survey question, and how the analysis being conducted. And then for qualitative, you need to also mention who are the respondents, what are the open-ended questions, and then how the analysis has been done. All right. So for quantitative, normally it involves using survey, observation, or it can also using experiments. So you can choose study that have a different approach. Okay, in the assignment, I would expect you to have like minimum three samples. Okay, three sample study samples. So choose a different strategy in the study. Although it's a quantitative, there must be a different way on how to do the study. For example, you can find one on the maybe using experiment, okay, and then second one maybe using a causal relationship, okay, and then maybe the third one maybe correlation study, okay, something like that. So you can choose to choose any study that related and then present it during the presentation. Alright, and then for qualitative, normally the data collection will involve interviews, focus groups, ethnography, and also literature review. So find several studies that have different data collection strategy, and then you discuss how the study conducted the interview, how the study conducted the focus group, and how the study conducted ethnography. Okay, and then maybe some of the study also, at the early stage, they do the literature review or the desk review. So you can also share how it being conducted. Okay, when to use qualitative versus quantitative? Okay, a rule of thumb for deciding whether to use qualitative or quantitative is, if you want to confirm something, okay, as I said earlier, a theory or hypothesis, you use quantitative. Okay, if you want to understand something, a concept, thoughts, or experiences, you will do qualitative. So the type you choose depends on whether you are inductive or deductive, based on your research questions, and whether you're doing experimental, correlational, or descriptive research. Okay, so you can choose a diverse way on each of the methods. Okay, and then present it during the assignments. Okay, I'm going to give this is example for quantitative research approach. For example, you survey 300 students at your university and ask them questions such as, on a scale from 1 to 5, how satisfied are you with your professors? Okay, so you can perform statistical analysis like a survey, and then draw conclusion like, on average, students rated their professors 4.4, for example. Okay, maybe you use the mean. Okay, how many of them actually responding, and then in on average you rated as 4.4. Okay, for example. And then for qualitative, you conduct in-depth interviews with 15 students and ask them open-ended questions, okay, such as, how satisfied are you with your studies? What is the most positive aspect of your study program, and what can be done to improve the study program? Okay, for example, these three is enough for the whole interview session. Okay, based on the answer you get, you can ask follow-up questions to clarify things, and then you transcribe all the interviews using transcription software and try to find the patterns. Okay, while in the mixed method approach, okay, you conduct interviews to find out how satisfied students with their studies. Alright, through open-ended question, you learn things you never thought about before and gain new insights. Okay, and then later you use a survey to test these insights on a larger scale. Okay, maybe at the first round, interview only 10 participants. And then when you survey, you do towards 200, for example. Okay, or it's also possible to start with survey to find out the overall trends, followed by interviews to better understand the reasons behind the trends. Okay, so these are mixed method strategy. Alright, in terms of analyzing the quantitative and the qualitative, alright, so analyze the quantitative, you can use Excel, SPSS, and more complicated and much more sophisticated software such as Pierce Amos, and you know, and there are a lot of application in the market. So try to get the analysis software or application that used in the study, and then you discuss about the application that used by the study. Whereas in the qualitative, okay, of course you can do manually, and then you can also use, for example, SSTI and Vivo, MaxQDA. So those are the type of the software that available to analyze thematic or thematic analysis. Alright, so how about mixed methods? So mixed method is a combination of quantitative and qualitative techniques. So under what circumstances might mixed method works? And under what circumstances might mixed method doesn't work? Okay, you think of epistemological perspective. Okay, remember the epistemology is how to know the reality. Okay, if you want to know the reality through numbers, okay, definitely quanti. If you want to know through narrative, definitely it's a qualitative. But if you want to know both, then definitely it's a mixed method. Okay. Alright, so some definition. Mixed method is a style of research that use procedures for conducting research that are typically applied in both quanti and qualitative. Okay, the purpose of the design is to build upon the synergy and strength that exists between quanti and quali in order to more fully understand a given phenomenon that is possible using either quanti or qualitative methods alone. So you know, you can always do only quanti, you can always do only quali, but if you want to like really go in both pragmatically, so you can use mixed method and you can explain both worlds. The research problem itself determines the choice of design. Okay, for example, using surveys, okay, to identify specific groups of students, and after that, conducting focus group with them to understand their views. Alright, or a series of interviews are conducted to ascertain the critical issues bothering students. Okay, first round, and then a survey of the student body is conducted using these issues as variables. Okay. So either way is also function. Alright. So basically, there are three types of design and three characteristics that differentiate types of method, mixed method design. First, the priority given, either the quantitative or qualitative first, and then the sequence. Okay, and then the data analysis techniques. Right, so these are the three types of design which you can also emphasize, which you can also elaborate in the assignment, okay, to show what type of mixed method that you choose. All right, there are three common design for mixed method. If you notice that the first one is Quali Quanti, which is the Quali is the heavily weighted, and then the Quanti is the minor study. Okay, so this one are more show that the qualitative is the main part, and then the Quanti Quali, okay, the explanatory mixed method design. So this is the quantitative is the data that collected first and more heavily weighted. Okay. And the third commons is Quanti Quali, which is concurrently, or both are weighted equally. Okay, so you can do both concurrent, and then it shows that and then you triangulate the result. Okay, so these are the third option. So the abbreviation of Quant and Quali are obvious. Okay, order and capitalization. So the first to be read or the capitalized abbreviation is dominant perspective and weighted more heavily. If both are capitalized, it means both are weighted equally. So maybe RQ1 is Quanti, RQ2 is Quali. So doesn't matter. It doesn't mean that it must be it must be in sequence, but it can be concurrently. Okay, so you can conduct the survey and then conduct the interview at the same time. All right, these are the 10 characteristics of mixed method design. So the title of the research includes terms that suggest more than one method is being used. Mixed methods, integrated, triangular, quantitative over qualitative. So these are the terms that suggest more than one method is being used. Okay, both quantitative and qualitative methods are used in the study. Okay, there are 10 characteristics of mixed method design. The researcher describes the kinds of mixed method being used. Okay, you have to show in the assignment what kinds of mixed method then being used, what type of data collection, which part indicates the narrative, which part numerical, of when both data being collected. So if you choose mixed method, okay, please put attention on this and then make sure that you highlight this in the study. Okay, the purpose statement or the research question indicate the types of method being used. Okay, normally the research question, as I said, how, why is more on qualitative, what is more on quantitative, what, how, why can be qualitative and also can be mixed method. Okay, questions are stated and described for both quantitative and qualitative approaches. Alright, this researcher indicates the sequencing of collecting qualitative or quantitative, okay? Quali means that Quanti is overweight and then Quali is minor. Quali is the majority, the heavyweight, and then the Quanti is a small part. or quan quali simultaneously. Okay, all right. Okay, this is the 8 questions that you can answer when you find a mixed method study. Does the study use at least one quantitative and one qualitative research strategy? Yes. If yes, then it's a mixed method. Does the study include a rationale for using a mixed method design? Okay. It must give reason and rationale why mixed method was used. Okay. Does study include a classification of the type of mixed method design? Okay. I've already explained what are the types of mixed method, whether it's a quan quali, quali quan, or quan quan quali equal. Okay. Does the study describe the priority given to quanti and qualitative data collection and the sequence of their use? Okay. Explain about the sequence of the use. And then, was the study feasible given the amount of data to be collected and concomitant issues of resources, time, and expertise? Of course, if you conduct mixed method, it's going to take longer time compared to you do only quantitative over qualitative. So, the amount of time must be given, okay, so that during the methodology section, you try to see whether the researcher has shown how long does it takes to conduct that study. And that the study include both quanti and qualitative. So as I said, you will know from the research question, okay, how and why, what, how, why. Okay, for example, what is definitely quantitative. What, how, why, okay, it can be quali, it can be mixed method. What, how, it can be also quali or can be mixed method. Okay, how, why is definitely qualitative. Okay, is it clear? So look into that. Okay, and then you will identify, you will recognize that the study is qualitative or quanti or mixed method. And then, does the study use appropriate data analysis techniques for the type of mixed method design? So this, look into the paper and then see what type of techniques they use in the data analysis, okay, that involve mixed method. So I assume for the mixed method, there must be a statistical analysis, and then there will be thematic analysis for the qualitative. Or it should start with the thematic analysis and then come up with the theme, and then the theme was used to develop questionnaire for the survey in the second part. Alright, and then data analysis. Okay, for qualitative, you will not analyze until you finish all the data collection. Okay, because you want to transcribe first the whole transcript and then come up with the themes and patterns to answer the whole research question. Okay, and then these are some education, okay, when they want to come up with the analysis. So make sure that you also look this in the paper, okay, in the previous paper, and then you highlight what would be the main elements that related to the data analysis in the qualitative. Okay, these are the process, iterative. You have to reread again, okay, in order to understand what will be the code, and then so that you can come up with the rich category and also final theme. Okay, and then you can also explain what is actually the steps that involve in the thematic analysis, okay, in order for you to understand how to analyze qualitative data. All right, so the main element in the thematic analysis is the theme. Okay, it's very important for you to have a general idea on how and make sure that the theme will emerge after the data analysis. Okay. Okay, this is how you make coding manually. Okay, before this, I think I still remember like 15 years ago when I did my master, I did it manually. So I remember I have to cut and paste, index cards just to see the similarity and to see the pattern to create the coding. But now with TestDI, it's so much easier. You can just code and then make a category and then also later make a theme. Okay, so please highlight in the research how the themes were derived from the study. All right, and then the data interpretation. Okay, for qualitative, explain on how the researcher interpret the data. Okay, because normally for qualitative, they will use interpretivism. So there will be segment or section that the researcher will interpret the data. Okay. All right. And then finally, the credibility. Each quantitative and qualitative have its own way to ensure the credibility of the study. Okay. In quantitative, they call it reliability. Okay. And then in qualitative, they call it trustworthiness. All right, so please make sure that you digest this from the paper, okay, and then highlight it during the presentation, okay, so that everyone will understand what is actually the meaning of credibility, or we call it reliability. All right, okay, so next part I want to share regarding the assignment brief number 3 on the research methodology video presentation. Okay, this assignment will weight 20%, okay, of the total course grade. Okay, the assignment aims to enhance your understanding of different research methodology and their application in the field of architecture. Okay, just choose architecture related study, okay, or paper. Okay, by collaborating in groups, you will explore first qualitative or quantitative or mixed method and analyze how this methodology are used in architecture research. So divide yourself, okay, not more than 4. Okay, for example, like maybe you can divide like 6 or maybe 9 groups. So for example, 3 will do quantitative, another 3 will do qualitative, and then another 3 will do mixed methods. Okay, so you need to prepare and submit a video presentation, okay, covering the following: understanding the chosen methodology. Okay, explain your group understanding of the selected research methodology. Okay, for example, if you choose qualitative, so explain first, what does it mean by qualitative research? And then discuss its key characteristics and advantages and also limitations. Okay, you can discuss, and then please, please, please cite your whatever statement that you mentioned. Okay, please have a citation. Okay, and then find in the literature review, select at least 3 previous papers from the architecture literature that utilize your chosen methodology, and then summarize how each study was conducted using the chosen methodology, and then highlight the research design, the data collection, the analysis method used in the studies. Okay, you extract all this information, okay, make it in the PowerPoint, and then discuss the relevance and impact of the chosen methodology on the research outcomes. All right, the video format: submit your presentation as a video file, and then the duration, the video should not exceed 10 minutes. Okay, 10 minutes is also already long. Okay, you can do maybe 5 to 6 minutes, for example. And then upload your video presentation to Padlet latest by 17 June before 12 midnight. All right. The evaluation criteria: first, understanding of methodology, how you explain and provide the in-depth understanding of the chosen research methodology, and then the quality of your literature review, the relevance, the depth, and the synthesis of the selected papers. How your presentation, okay, whether it's interesting or not, boring or interesting, okay, is your creativity in terms of clarity, coherence, and engagement in the video presentation. And then group collaboration, effective collaboration and distribution of work among group members. Please give credit at the end of the video, the role of each of the participants, okay, so that I can see who doing what. And then the important dates, group formation deadline is on the 12th June. Please, I hope the class rep will come up with the list, who will be in the group, and then what method that you will choose. And then the submission of the video presentation on the 17th June 2024. Okay, please make sure all sources are cited in APA style within your video presentation and put it at the end of your slide. Okay, and then good luck, and I look forward to your insightful presentation. Thank you.